In the world of boxing, we know that punching power is great to have, but it is actually speed that kills.
Look at the speed of Meldrick Taylor's flurry.
It doesn't matter how strong you are if you can't connect with your punches. Greater hand speed allows this awesome phenomenon to happen with greater frequency. All the fighters on this list are great examples of that idea at work.
I was amazed at the speed and power together.
None of them are particularly devastating one-punch knockout fighters, but they have extraordinary hand speed, which makes them dangerous. Ukrainian master Aleksandar Usyk is the first boxer in history to hold all four major world championships at cruiserweight.
You cannot train harder than this guy. It's impossible. He's training three times a day. You can't train harder.
Usyk unanimously outpointed Murat Gassiev to become undisputed world cruiserweight champion after delivering a boxing masterclass.
Я живу этим. Я вот вот такой вот я есть. То есть, если я танцую, значит мне это нравится. Если я смеюсь, значит это мне нравится.
In his last fight, he scored a brutal 8-round TKO of Tony Bellew, and now he was moving up to the heavyweight division to look for better and bigger challenges.
Bringing Usyk to heavyweight will bring some new spirit to heavyweight division.
No one has boxing ability or hand speed at cruiserweight or heavyweight like Usyk, and the clamor to see him fight the best at heavyweight has already started. Chris Eubank Jr. is one of those fighters who can truthfully state that boxing is in his blood, and he is the son of former WBO middleweight and super middleweight champion Chris Sr.
Jr. is not a good fighter, he's a great fighter.
Again, he's shooting Eubank, isn't it?
But he has it to prove.
Yoderin being forced backwards, left under a step-up!
With the win over Arthur Abraham, Eubank earned the final slot in the World Boxing Super Series.
Of a shot here, cracking right uppercut from Eubank.
In semi-final against George Groves, Eubank struggled to gain a foothold in their eventual fight, losing on the scorecards.
Takes a right uppercut and a chopping right hand from Groves, closing second of the 12th and final round.
Eubank has amazing potential, but he needs help, and he needs it fast.
I'm in the gym every day, I'm getting better by each day, and you can see it in the performances.
Against a certain level of opponent, or against a certain style, those multi-punch flurries will work wonders. A slick Cuban boxer who has been successful both as an amateur and a professional, Guillermo Rigondeaux is truly impressive talent.
Oh, perfect, straight, left, and a right hand.
All the Cubans that have turned pro, he's the guy I was most excited about.
And if anyone was born with the physical tools required to maximize the Cuban style to its fullest measure, it is Rigondeaux.
On points, accumulating points.
His fleet of hand and foot, he has legitimate knockout power in both hands, and is blessed with the dexterity of a juggler and the balance of a trapeze artist. He has consistently sought fights against the biggest and best names in his division, proved his worth against Donaire in his biggest win.
Talking about it. See it, Brock.
Oh! Oh!
Davis developed into a successful amateur fighter, accumulating a 206-15 record before making his professional debut in 2013.
Oh, lightning quick power.
He is a two-time world champion and undoubtedly the biggest name in the super featherweight division.
I believe I have, you know, the skills to beat anyone they have in front of me.
Davis has the tools to become not only one of the best fighters of his generation, but also turn himself into a household name and potentially help fill the void of box office stars in the sport since the retirement of Floyd Mayweather Jr.
All he has done was beat the fighters that was put in front of him. Same thing that I done.
He's got hand speed. He's got power. He's tenacious in the ring. He's just a really special fighter. It was evident Crawford was someone special after a spectacular knockout win over Jurjorkis Gamboa in 2014.
Hard counter shot by Terence Crawford. Down goes Gamboa.
He has a complete arsenal of dazzling hurtful punches and he never fails to impress.
Pretty much nothing I can't do in the ring.
But he doesn't talk a lot of trash.
I can fight going forward, I can fight going backwards.
Left to the body there.
I can fight going side to side. Look at myself as a complete fighter.
He is the finest switch hitter and he is equally brilliant whether he is fighting orthodox or southpaw. Crawford has mesmerizing hand speed, great defensive skills, and when he sets out to finish off opponents, he is electrifying. This super featherweight American from California and clearly with Mexican descent has the world of social media in a buzz.
He has been in.
In 2-3 years, Ryan's gonna be the beast that nobody's gonna be able to beat him.
Garcia has never had a big fight, he has never faced a top opponent, and he has only 18 professional bouts. But he has the charisma, and he has the it factor.
Man, I can do this whenever I want. There it is, though!
Garcia, the 2017 Prospect of the Year. He has grown his fan base on social media in large part thanks to his boyish good looks and the entertaining and fun-filled training videos he regularly posts. But Garcia also is more than just a pretty face.
My improvements are even gonna get better and better. My fights are gonna get better and better.
He lands right hooks, with his hands back up in guard position before the opponent even registers that the punch was thrown.
Do I think I'm ready for a world title this year? Hell yes!
He says, Garcia and Garcia comes away with a spectacular knockout.
Manny Pacquiao's performance against Thurman proved that he still possessed his reflexes, hand speed and footwork.
Pacquiao!
God gave me this ability to continue my career for a purpose.
Pacquiao is now 10 years removed from the glorious 12-month high point of his ring career when he pulverized Oscar De La Hoya, Ricky Hatton and Miguel Cotto to become a global icon.
He had everything. I was amazed at the speed and power together.
Notable victories over Marco Antonio Barrera, Eric Morales and Juan Manuel Marquez followed as Pacquiao became boxing's most marketable feel-good story. Legends die hard in boxing, and the 8-division world champion Manny Pacquiao, even at 40 years of age, doesn't plan on going away anytime soon. Lomachenko is most known for a legendary amateur career that saw him win 2 Olympic gold medals across an incredible 396-1 run.
He fought Gary Russell, who has incredible speed, and it turned out in the fight in their exchanges.
Although he is nearly an inch and a half shorter than the average lightweight fighter, he uses a combination of excellent footwork and exceptional hand speed to control distance and inflict heavy damage.
By how Loma fights, we haven't seen that. Maybe since the first young Ali.
Pacquiao's workout point is increasing from all areas.
He has deadly accuracy and is adept at slipping punches through an opponent's guard.
I will try show my all my skill and try show best my style.
He has beaten boxers and sluggers, taller and shorter foes. You name them, he's beaten everyone. Amir Khan has the type of skill set that would have made him a huge star in boxing.
Pressure, speed, power, and aggression.
In the eyes of judges, incidentally.
He's a good fighter. He's very fast. He moves well.
His hands are dangerously fast.
And he's fighting.
He routed other quick men in judo and Malinaji.
Right now.
He was punch perfect against Luis Collazo and Devon Alexander.
You know, we have two fighters here. Oh my!
And was too quick even after a two-way jump for the also speedy Saul Alvarez through most of their fight. The problem he often runs into is that he is so quick and willing to let his hands go that he often neglects his defense. The 31-year-old is undoubtedly one of the most exciting athletes on the circuit.
Capitol Heights, Maryland, very compactly built.
A lot of people talk about my hand speed. We do everything in 20-ounce gloves. I shadow box. I mean, I hit the mitts in 20-ounce gloves.
He's so fast, it is hard to tell what punch he uses to knock his opponents out in some of the clips in the video. And it is not until seeing the slow motion replay that you know which one did it. After starting his professional career with 24 straight wins, Gary Russell Jr. finally got his first world title shot against Vasyl Lomachenko. Lomachenko dominated most of the fight before winning by a majority decision.